Okay, YouTube, got the flex plate cleaned off here. I removed the sticker, wiped everything down with some acetone there to clean it off really well. And then what I did along the side is I marked off approximately 5/8 inch increments so I could get 19 strips of tape from edge to edge. And then I just worked from one edge, held a little extra bit of tape, stretched it down to the other edge, and cut it off flush down here. And you can just kind of stretch the tape and keep an eye on the mark, and you just want to keep the half inch strip of tape between the marks there. And yeah, they came out pretty good. I got a couple here that were kind of close together, but that's okay. Have to get in here with a razor blade and peel up the protective backing on the double stick tape. And then the other thing I did, I took my Garolite sheet and gave it a light sanding with an orbital or random orbit sander, and then wiped that down with acetone as well. So once I get all these strips peeled off, it's time to put the Garolite on the flex plate. The other thing I did, I took a little plastic card and ran down all the tape to work the bubbles out. And I think I got all of them out. Some of the backing tape makes a lump in the surface, but I think the adhesive is all stuck down. I've got all the little bubbles worked out there. Let me get all the protective tape peeled off of there, and we'll see what it looks like. Okay, YouTube, success. That worked pretty well. So there we got the Garolite on top and the steel plate on the bottom. I think if I were to do this again, I would go for the 32nd inch, because this got really stiff. I mean, it's still flexible. You can see I can bend it, but it came out quite a bit stiffer than I expected it would. So I don't know if you're supposed to leave this shiny or if you're supposed to rough it up with sandpaper. That's why I thought the little bit thicker material, 16th of an inch, which is what, 1.6 millimeters, would be give me a longer life, and it should hold pretty flat. And there we go, YouTube. Got the Garolite flex plate working. So I'm doing a few calibration prints. I've changed to a 0.6 millimeter nozzle at the same time. I've got to dial in the print bed and the nozzle size at the same time. But yeah, look at that. There's the nylon sticks really well there. So all I did to the Garolite is I took some green Scotchbrite and just kind of took the shine off the surface, wiped it down with some acetone to get all the dust and fingerprints and everything off. To install it, it was a little time consuming. That black knob in the back, that's the Z stop adjustment. That's where you set where the bed comes up to for the home position. I was up near the top, and when I went to the added thickness of the Garolite, I couldn't adjust the knob anymore. So what I had to do was come into the bed leveling screws and screw them down probably about 5 turns each. And then I had to re-level the bed after I did that. So then when I switch to the build tack flex plate, I'll have to figure out how many turns on the screw that equals. So you just have to reset the bed height between the two prints or the two build plates. But look at that, there we go. Everything's stuck down, no warping. This is a pretty small part, but see there, it's stuck down pretty well. Nylon filament is stringy there, so you can see. Yeah, so what I'm trying to get dialed in here is the extrusion multiplier. I used to use 75% with the 0.4 millimeter nozzle, but I think I'm here at 85%. Might actually go up a little higher. Maybe I'll try 90. So I'm getting pretty good fill here. Still a little bit rough. You can see how I got the surface roughed up a little bit. and that's where I was printing. If you can see, the gets a little shiny right there where you print. So these are the screws I had to adjust. There's two on each side, so I screwed them down about five turns, because what I wanted to do was be able to adjust the black screw clear to the top and still have a little bit of a gap here, so I have a little bit of adjustment room. Okay, YouTube. Looks like the parts printed okay. Had to do a few adjustments on the settings. I guess the main thing I did was add a brim here to get the bed adhesion on these smaller parts. So I also tried a few other things. I actually tried heating the bed. Actually, up here in the attic, it's about 40 degrees C, so the bed is basically the ambient temperature. But I tried heating it to 50, and I had trouble with the parts. They were lifting up. That didn't work, so actually running on an unheated bed is the way to go. Yeah, let me try to peel these off and show you what they look like. Yeah, and there we go. Parts finished printing. Yeah, I think they came out pretty good. I got the extrusion factor and outside printing speed dialed in. Looks like they're pretty solid on top. Yeah, all I have to do is just trim off the brim on these parts and they are ready to go. Yeah, there's a little bit of cleanup. You get with the nylon, you do get a bit of stringing. There's really no way to eliminate that. It's kind of part of the nature of the material. It's very stringy. I guess with these smaller parts, you do need a brim because there's just not enough surface area compared to the height. Between the height and the small diameter, they tend to pull loose pretty easy. So print them with a brim and they're good to go. So yeah, there's the Garolite flex plate. So I think that's going to work pretty good. No heat and no bed prep, other than just that's about all you need to do. Hit it with a little Scotchbrite pad and clean it off with some alcohol. Get the fingerprints off of there and it's good to go. I'll try to wrap this up here. If you have any questions about the materials I use, post up in the comment section below. I'll put links to the Garolite and the BuildTac flex plate in the video description, and I'll put some other videos over here on the left side you might be interested in. And as always, thanks for watching.